It's 12 o'clock on a Wednesday and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
I'm Sean.
I'm Wayne.
Well, it's kind of like a growl. Growl. He's a bit groovy today.
He was out in the bar last night. We got him up to film a show and he's feeling a bit rough this morning.
Oh, come on, Sean.
Just ruined the whole show.
Comedy. It's nearly lads, ladies and gentlemen.
Yay!
Not this weekend, next weekend, Saturday night, John Kerry. Sunday, we've got Morgan Strebler, Luca Volpe, we've got Aaron Jones and Tom Wright, and special guests taking part on the day as well. Some new dealers, some people visiting from abroad as well.
Yeah.
Coming to show you their wares, as well as new items from World Magic Shop, including one which took the Magic World by storm at Magic Live, and the trailer's getting released in a few days' time. Something from me and you, Wayne.
It is
a good one.
It is.
So about five new items coming out from World Magic Shop. First of all, we've got this, which is not new from World Magic Shop. It's new from Jeff Brace and Josh
Januski.
I'm sure you say his name Januski. Like that. Withdrawal. Withdrawal. So let's synopsisize the effect. First of all, you have a Starbucks kind of gift card. It's got a $25 gift card.
Yeah.
And what you do, you visually produce from that $25 gift card a dollar bill. But the cool thing is it kind of changes and the emblem bit in the corner changes to $24.
Yeah.
Like the value's actually gone down. And then when you take out the $10 bill, it becomes $14 and then you can hand the card out for examination. Initial thoughts, Wayne, what did you like about it?
Coffee shop magic, mate.
I do love coffee shop magic.
I love the moment when you're not out doing a gig and someone comes up to you and says, why are you having a quick coffee? Oh, show us some magic. This is lovely.
So it when you were out with that lady the other day and you texted me and said I had a bit of coffee shop magic the other day, was that what that was on
it
about?
It was very similar.
Right,
very similar.
Okay.
Yeah, very similar.
So you like it because it's coffee shop magic.
Coffee shop magic. You're not actually at a gig. I certainly wouldn't be...
What do you like about it, Sean?
I think the perv, it's good, but I like it, it works.
Just say what you like about it.
If I was trying to make a coffee shop my own, and I wanted to impress all the staff, I'd go in and pay for my coffee like that. You go, bam, that's a perfect trick to show the barista at the coffee shop. What's nice about it from an effects point of view, it is incredibly visual.
Yeah.
So anybody that's seen Steve Rose thing with the eight ball when it pops off, it's that type of visual magic. So you, and so, it's visual eye candy.
So what I liked about it is I like the fact that the gimmick, which is very well made, takes a little bit of construction. You get your 30-minute download and about 15 minutes of that is showing you how to construct the gimmick, and then you get Josh taking you through all the handling.
Yeah.
What I liked about it is the gimmick cleans itself up during the effect. Mm. I've never seen anything like that using this method. So you probably watched the trailer and you went, I know what that is.
Yeah.
That's a gimmick that rhymes with slap. And you're probably thinking that's what that is. But actually, it's a little bit cleverer than that because the gimmick does clean itself up in the action of removing these dollar bills. At the end, you can hand that card out for complete examination.
Okay.
So that's what I liked about it. Anything you didn't dislike about it, Wayne?
Setting it all up isn't my
You said cup. You like making things.
I do. No, not setting it up in between the tricks, stuff like that. I actually quite like getting a trick and opening it up and thinking, oh, I've got to make this up now. I quite like doing craft stuff like that. It's quite good fun. I don't think that it's not going to be one of those things that I'm going to perform at a gig. It's just not for that
coffee
moment.
Shop magic.
It is. It's for a coffee shop, and I think it's.
So
a
you didn't like the fact that you have to set it up while you're doing it.
Yeah, while you're doing it and stuff like that. In between.
Comes in dollar version. Comes in pound version. Comes in euro version as well. Anything you didn't like about it, Sean?
If I bought this, it would be so I could do it once to some friend. So it's not going to be a repeat gigger.
Yeah.
But if I was going to coffee shops with friends regularly, then it would be something that I'd have to buy. So I could show it to do it once,
Yeah. I'm not sure if there was something I particularly didn't like about it. It's certainly not for me. But it's just not something that I would perform. So I don't really do coffee shop magic. I didn't like the fact that it's not ready to perform, and you did need some assembly there, but like Wayne says, some people actually enjoy the arts and crafts moment. But on the whole, it's a good product.
It
it's
is.
Very clever. I like the fact that it does clean up, and you've actually got two bangs for your buck as it were, no pun intended, when you actually produce two items. So you've got, normally these gimmicks, they only produce the one thing, but you've got one, and maybe that's the sort of thing that makes your spectator pull focus on it, go, oh yeah, and it's changed just there. And then you follow it up with that second production. So all these are quite unique to this effect, something that I've not seen when gimmicks are produced like this, or have been produced like this in the past. How much are you going to give it, Wayne?
I'm going to give it 78%.
79% from me.
I'm going to give it exactly 81%. 81%. I'm not going to use it, but actually I liked it very much so because it cleans itself up at the end.
And next up we've got The Art of Rubber Band, not bands, I think rubber band, by Calvin Liu.
So this is kind of like a DVD. It's about 40 minutes. Quite succinct, isn't it? It's got... you know, a kind of a run through and then an explanation after. Yeah. What did you like about the effects on this DVD, first of all, Wayne?
I didn't get blown away by any of them, I must admit.
What is it first?
There's a selection of different types of rubber band effects on there. So an appearing rubber band out of nowhere, an on-off type linking rubber band thing.
We'll go through some of the effects.
Yeah. You know what? There wasn't anything in there which made me want to sit up and go, how is that working? I was kind of looking at it and thinking, yeah, you could have done it like that, could have done it like this. And I think, you know, if you're into your rubber band magic already, then you are going to sit there.
Anything you liked about it, Sean?
Nothing set my world on fire with this. I think a lot of it you have to be viewing straight on. Maybe I wouldn't be able to be comfortable doing it out and about.
Definitely.
Well, going on from that point. The first effect on the DVD was unbanded, and this was the thing on the trailer. I thought that is nice. And it was the bit where he had the blue rubber band around his hand. He kind of slapped it and it just changed visually to a paperclip.
Yeah.
And I thought that was great. Now, I don't want to say too much about how it's done, but I was shocked to see the explanation. And if you were there in person, you would just kind of go, all right? Yeah, so it's not an effect for real life. And I don't think they make that clear on the trailer, that is purely an effect for social media.
Yeah.
Because it's too fast in a tight frame to see exactly what's going on. But in real life, you would literally go, okay.
Yeah.
And that's kind of the secret. And there's a lot of effects on this that kind of go down that route where you're looking at it, and they really suit perhaps social media, where Sean says, where you've got that camera looking straight on. I'm trying to think of... RGB one-handed was a routine where he got one coloured band and he just shakes it and it changes colour. Now, it looks great if you're doing it straight to the camera like this and you were making an elastic band showreel and you've got multiple moments of magic. But if I was stood at the side of Sean now watching him do it, I would see clearly how he was doing it. And there is no way that he could hide this angle from me unless he turned right around and was doing it like this in front of me.
There is a market, right?
But it's
a very narrow market, and I mentioned it to you over in the office before. And I think this is a better market for all of rubber band magic. I think rubber band magic is better on a big screen in a cabaret setting than it is close up.
Totally disagree.
You disagree, but that's what I think. But I think some of the things, if you were trying to put like a manipac together with the bands, I'm not saying I'd want to do that, I definitely wouldn't want to do that, but I think maybe there'd be some sort of place for some of the visual colour changes straight onto the camera to the audience to see.
What Sean is saying is if you're going to use the material off this DVD, you really need to be working to a camera. Yeah. And only if you're working to a camera and you've not got some guy at the side of you going, well, open your hand, show me in your other hand. Because that's what happens in the UK. They're not all polite
or anywhere else. You know, you're doing close to magic, you're a bit of a crowd pick. And unless you're performing as just that, people are going, if you're just going around performing one-on-one magic to people, then you're not really doing
None of this magic on this DVD stands up to live performance conditions, the sort of which that you would experience in the UK. Going back to your point, I have to disagree. Wayne, you've seen me doing my elastic bands.
I have, yeah.
People enjoy elastic band magic, don't they?
Of course they do. They
and
really
with the
do.
Bits that I do some like unique performance bits with elastic bands. The thing is, this is a completely different product to something that you would see from the likes of Marcus Eddy and Joe Rindflesh, for example. Yes. Marcus Eddy's got some unbelievable elastic band moves that I know a lot of professional workers use. Joe Rindflesh, well, he's like the godfather of elastic band magic. He is the man. And he put out a download recently that's just like literally like $5.
Yeah.
And it's like the symphony of rubber bands. And all this is workable stuff that you can actually work in front of people, linking, unlinking, absolutely unbelievable magic. And this is made for workers in the real world. The problem is, with Calvin, even though I think his magic is very good, very original, very skillful.
Yeah.
It's not actually for workers. It's just purely for social media. And when I saw that first effect where he went like this, and I thought, that looks great on the trailer. Maybe I could use that in my elastic band set.
I couldn't believe it when I saw how it was done after what he was doing.
When you see The Secret and you think, is that seriously?
Never gonna work.
And you think that is a viable solution for a magic plot. But it's not.
But I think as well, for maybe more experienced magicians that have been into it for a little while, given what elastic bands are made of and what we know they're capable of doing, I think if you wanted to do that type of transposition effect, it wouldn't take you a long time to figure out a practical way of doing that type of thing with an elastic band.
Yeah, well, I can think of one version, actually, that would clean up for you certainly would not leave a spectator going like this and seeing exactly where that blue band goes off to. That was my main problem with a lot of this DVD. The only positive I could find is there's lots of visual moments if you wanted to make like a montage of elastic band effects. But as for real world performances...
You're not going to be blown away with that. You're just not going to be blown away.
Real world performances, there's nothing here that makes you go, wow. And unfortunately, I can only give this about 32%. And I was really hoping that I could give it a lot more. Even the crazy man's handcuffs thing that you said you liked.
That was the best thing on the video.
I thought, maybe I can use this and use it with crazy man's handcuffs. Yeah. But at the end of the day, the angles are pretty terrible because when I perform that, I am actually in the real world, not in a camera, and I'm normally surrounded on all sides.
It's the pacing of what your routine needs to be for that not to look awkward. For example, I can imagine how you do crazy man's handcuffs and I'll be very, very magical. And very slowly coming through in it. And of all of a sudden to mix that into a routine where you're going like that, they wouldn't actually go with your routine.
It could
only go with a routine that was dun 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 dun.
How much are you going to give it?
I like the way... I like how it's explained. It's really good and it works in any language. Yeah. You can see that. I just don't like the tricks on it. I'm 24% from me, I think.
Yeah, I'm going to give it 35.
Yeah, very good teaching, very well shot. I think this guy's a huge talent. I hope we see more from him, but maybe with something else.
Yeah.
Maybe with his working set in the real world.
Okay, so next up we've got Captive by Jimmy Strange. I've met Jimmy a few times. This is a cap of a Sharpie pen that you place on the table. And you can put a glass over it, make a magical gesture, and the cap will fall over.
What did you like about it, Wayne?
You know what? I feel bad about it, really, because I do know Jimmy, but this really isn't for me, mate. This just didn't do it. No, it just wasn't magical enough for me. It falls over. I can think of a very much easier way of actually executing the effect if I wanted to do something like that. The setup for it and the in between as well, going from... You just can't... It just did not do it for me. What did you think, Sean?
It's what it is, and we've used this expression on the show before. It's a meh. No one's going to go, oh my God, that's amazing. Hear that trick again? Yeah, I made the cap
but
fall over.
You rated the fall pen.
I'd like the fall pen. I like the Banachek, you know, the original Banachek pen.
What's the difference? Just playing devil's advocate. Why is the difference?
Because let's say the fall pen is on top of a glass. And people, and you're away from it, and it there's no way it can possibly fall off. Even if the table was knocked, you could see it'd be obvious that the table's knocked away, it fall off. It actually slowly goes there. It looks like magic. The four pair, the cap thing. Some you could be at TGI Fridays doing table magic. The kid comes over to the table, and it falls over because the table's been knocked like that.
Yeah,
and
that's the effect.
And it looks, what I just did then
and
is
the
effect.
That is the effect, yeah.
What just happened then with me knocking my knee on the table, and that's the problem.
It's not, what I did like about it, I'll say what I did like about it, I like the fact that, like the fall pen, you can be a long way away from the table when it happens. And on our YouTube channel, somebody put the explanation, well, it's obviously magnets. And I think that's a fair point. It can look like a magnet. This, you know, you've got a bit of metal in the cap and you're moving it with a magnet or something like that. But it's not magnets. It is actually a very, very ingenious method.
Yeah.
And Jimmy has got an amazing mind when it comes to his methods, to his effects.
Yeah, he's done some nice stuff.
And it is, in some ways, ingenious. It's so ingenious how it actually works, and yet the level of effect that it actually produces, like Sean says, is a bit of a moment. And that is because that when a cap falls over, it's not that impressive. You've not got that staging to it, like a mini illusion.
It's not even to do with the stage, it's because of how light a cap is. If the cap was a heavy bit of brass and it fell over, then people would go, oh, that's interesting. Because of how light and flimsy
a cap is. It's so small, it looks like
what
it
about
could
the
fall
setup
over?
And setting it up in between performances?
Well, if you're going to do it in between, this isn't for that. You can't do it in between tables and that. This is a one off performance if you're doing one of these seance type. Okay. Evenings. That's what it's for.
So it might suit that.
It might do that. There's no way that you could take this away now and reset it. Well, you could. You had to go into the gents and you had to mess around with it. You can't do it in public. Now, you know there are some effects that you can actually set up between tables. So you turn around
just
from
as
here,
you're walking.
Yeah, walking over there. You've reset the new. You can't do that with this.
Yeah,
you just won't be able to do it. And it's and I totally agree with Sean there. It's just not a big enough effect for it to go out. What is going on? How's that working? People will go, oh, well, did the table get knocked? Do it again then. And that's the first thing they will say. Do it again. I think the table was knocked.
Well, it's when this is, and we had a look on the website and prices and things. You're buying this or the full pen. It's the same price.
Same price, yeah.
The full pen, it's a bigger effect. More people can see it. It looks more magical. It resets almost things. Not instantly, but just by it automatically resets itself. And by the time you've got to that bit in the routine where you need to do it at the next table, the full pen will have reset itself automatically. Yeah. It's a no-brainer.
It's a comparison, isn't it? It is a no-brainer. It's an ingenious solution to a plot, but actually the plot is not that engaging as far as I'm concerned when you're comparing it to a full pen. Jimmy is a genius. This just isn't one of his greatest
hits. This ain't the one, Jimmy. I've seen you do some
if we're being
much
honest,
better stuff than this, mate.
You know, it's not his best effect. But his creativity is incomparable. It's amazing.
It is.
But the way it works, you're looking at it, you're going, that's very clever. How did he think that up? But actually,
you want to give
the effect's not good enough.
You want to give it a high mark because it's
so
of
clever.
How clever the way they've made it.
At a gig could go, everybody, gather round, look what's actually going on here. People would be like, well, that is brilliant.
Maybe that's amazing.
Maybe that's
why you buy it, so you can actually go, well, we don't normally do this, but I'll actually show you how it works.
You can't do that. And you film it on a Sony phone.
Yeah.
At a high frame rate, and you show it in slow motion.
Yeah, that'd be brilliant.
That's exactly what you need to do. How much are you going to give it, Wayne?
Jimmy, I'm really sorry, mate. I can only give this 35.
I'm going to stick to my 24%.
Again. I was going to say exactly 30%. Yeah, it's not that good.
Sorry.
Final review of the week, and it's getting a worker of the week.
It's a good one.
We really like this.
Yeah.
It's called Linko. And it's by Ben Williams, a very creative magician from the UK.
He is.
And I was doing a gig with him very recently in London, actually. And it's his routine for the linking mints, the linking lifesavers or polo mints, depending on what part of the world you're from. And we're all unanimous. We all love this. What do you like about it, Wayne?
Well, it's that old classic, isn't it? It's an old classic. It's all brought to life again. But now... we've got this beautiful visual moment.
When you say old classic, do you mean linking rings?
No, the linking polo idea.
Because it has been out before, hasn't it?
It has been out before.
This is a complete study with the packet.
It is, yeah. This looks brilliant. This is an absolutely wonderful piece. And once again, you don't have to be out performing magic. You're not going to... Well, you will. You can go around doing it at tables. But it's just one of those moments where you... Do you want them in? Do you want them in?
Look, I would actually do this at gigs.
Yeah, you, oh, no, I'm not
even
saying...
Even though it seems relaxed, I would do this.
You would definitely do it at gigs.
And I'll tell you what I do at gigs. Well, this is a bit, because we're just giving a bit here. The polos thing, there's loads of different ways of linking the polos.
Yeah.
And one of them that I really like, more importantly, there's a way into the routine, which is really visual, which actually uses the polo packet,
yeah.
Where you actually link the O's in the word polo, you actually link visually the O's together, and it looks really great. All the users are really going to be impressed.
You see,
I would do
that after.
At the end, and yeah. Leave them with the mints.
I would take them out. I mentioned it to Sean earlier. We both are in love with the flash paper idea. Mm. And I've said this before on the Wizard product review, when I was filming with Mike Fitch years ago, I always remember him saying this to me, the psychology of magic. Add flash paper to any effect, it instantly becomes 20% more impressive. And he's right.
20% more impressive and 100% more useful. Because if you're at a gig and you have the flash paper going off, the whole... We work with Mark Oberon the other night, and he does a bit with flash paper. The whole room looks, oh God, there's fire over there, what's going on? I want him at my table, he's doing magic with fire. So instantly, you know...
You're busting the gut doing incredible card moves, flicking cards, and he's just lighting a bit of flash paper, and they're going, get that guy over.
Well, I did get 2 standing ovations.
All right, sore subject.
Here we go.
But yeah, the effect is that you can basically take 2 polo mints out of the packet, link them either in your own hands visually or in the spectator's hands, or using flash paper in the glass, which looks awesome. Very bulletproof handling here.
It's brilliant.
And at the end, it's completely examinable. They can, if you buy like an additional gimmick that's available from most supermarkets, you can give them the mints link. They can check it. They can't find anything. They can't see anything. They can even eat them. Those polo mints are linked permanently together. And then this absolute killer, you then pick the packet up off the table, you show it both sides, kind of show it like this, like you're in a canoe, and then you hold it up and then you pull the O from one side to the other, and the O links on visually.
I want to do it.
I've already been out and bought all the stuff to do
I know.
This is one of my things. I'm doing some video next week, and this is one of the things that I am going to be doing.
Of course you are. It's incredible. It's an incredible moment of magic. Stephen Bridges.
Yeah.
He does the video performance, and there's a guy that's got, you know, a huge YouTube channel, and he's choosing it as one of the bits of magic that he's putting on there.
Well, think about it.
So there you go.
It's normal objects. It's an impossible object that they can keep and examine. As an impossible objects go, I know you do the bending wine glass, but this is just something to leave them with as well. It's another one of them, and it can be repeated at every table if you wanted to do it.
What I liked, we saw a lecture by one of the greatest technicians and minds in magic recently at the Circle.
Hmm.
Do you remember the lecture by Michael Vincent? And he talked about conversational magic.
Yeah.
And he said, now, it's lovely, really got me thinking. He said he's trying to make all his magic more conversational. Mm. So he's not just performing, it's like you doing a show for everybody and they're listening and you're talking. And he tries to make it more relaxed and engineer conversations, because that's when you build better relationships with your clients.
Mm-hmm.
And I love the fact that this could be almost a moment where, say you're at a wedding and you're doing that bit in the photos and you've done a few bits, and then it almost becomes a little bit conversational. They're asking you about how you got interested in magic, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
And during that moment that seems very relaxed, you take these polo mints out, one here. I tell you what, can we try something? Yeah. You know, I bet you could even give somebody that packet to hold on to.
Yeah, absolutely.
While you took the other mints, put them in the packet, lit them, they join up, and then you offer mints round to everybody. And it's so relaxed, and yet you've done something absolutely incredible in that conversational moment. And that's where I'm going to use it, right at the end of a set at a wedding booking. I think it's brilliant.
Yeah, when they think the magic's over.
Yes.
When they think the magic's over, yeah, do you want a mint? Do you want a mint?
Putting the things in your pockets, and the mints come out. Oh, yeah, sorry, yeah, do you want a mint?
I love it. I think it's brilliant. It's such a great moment.
So we all love it. It's getting the worker of the week. If you order it from worldmagicshop.com by Friday at midnight, you will get sent free with your order. Cameron Francis, another amazing creative magician, you will get sent his At the Table lecture DVD along with your order. Absolutely free. And don't forget, if you increase your order and you've got £50 worth of products in your order, it will be completely free shipping for the whole lot. But remember, it doesn't say anything on the site. You just order it by 12 o'clock midnight on Friday, and the Cameron Francis lecture DVD will be shipped automatically with your order. Because every day somebody messages in and goes, I've ordered that, but it didn't say anything. It will happen automatically.
It just goes automatically.
Automatically on the system. You'll get it sent as long as you get your order in by midnight on Friday. Mm. We're off to start getting all the staging ready for Lads, because we've got a huge video projector this year.
Not long.
We have the big screen TV, but this time we've got a massive cinema screen and a new set and that kind of thing. There's loads to put together. Morgan's doing a brand new lecture. Luke is doing a brand new lecture. Aaron and Tom are doing brand
Aaron
new
and
unseen
Come
material.
On.
And John's going to be there the night before. John is just the night before and on his dealer stand during the day. But he's taking care of the session. We're going to see how that evolves organically. The night before.
Yeah.
Lads, 2017, the evening of the 23rd. At the hotel, a relaxed affair in the bar hosted by John. And then next day, the 24th, if you're staying over at the hotel, you don't need to, but if you're staying over at the hotel, 24th of September, all day long, Lectures and Dealers, hosted by worldmagicshop.com. It's Lads 2017. It's less than 2 weeks away. We hope to see you there. Until next time on the Wizard Product Review, I'm Dave.
I'm Sean.
I'm Wayne.
See you next time on the Wizard Product Review.
Everyone, this is Cameron Francis, and I just got done doing my At the Table lecture experience, and it was awesome. So we went out into the real world to perform some of these effects, and one of the tricks was a coin effect, which I've never published before, which you're going to get to see.
Okay, this is embarrassing. I'm sorry, Brie. I apologize. You know, I keep a spare, though, just in case this happens. That's my third coin right here, okay? So I've got one, I've got two, I've got...
I also did a signed card to card box that is just a normal ungimmick card box that you can do anytime, anywhere.
Go ahead, take the card out yourself. You can reach in there, it's fine. Yeah, you're not gonna break anything, it's just a card box.
But you're gonna learn some really cool material, including a pack a trick. You can just pull the cards out of the normal deck and it has a totally surprise royal flush ending.
No, do you lose cards out?
Oh, wow.
Oh,
whoa.
That was genuine surprise.
You got a royal flush right there. Yeah, that's pretty good.
You're also going to learn my card at any number routine that fries everyone called convergence.
We don't know what this card is, but if choice and chance have converged, they can create fate. Didn't care to turn my card over. And there it is, the four.
You're also going to learn one of Greg's favorite tricks. It's the last trick in the lecture. It's called creation. And it's a real fooler. And
then this is actually one of the cleverest tricks, I think, in the lecture.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, very deceptive.
Yeah, it is. It's very,
and direct.
It's very direct. It's a very direct trick.
You are going to learn that and so much more. So be sure to join me at the table.